Hello, Ace. This is RetroTK2, and today you'll learn how to declare variables in C#. You'll also learn some of the basic functionality of the equals operator. If you haven't already, Ace, I'd advise you to download the channel files that accompany this video. Card should be on your screen now. So let's get started. Well, what is a variable, Ace? According to MSDN, a variable represents a numeric or string value or an object of a class. The value that the variable stores may change, but the name stays the same. A variable is one type of field. In C#, variables are declared with a specific data type and a label. I really didn't want to get onto the topic of variables until a little later in this series, Ace, but I felt I had to in order to make the next couple of tutorials easier. I'll be glossing over quite a lot of important information here, since I want just enough to get us through the next tutorial. Open up Unity and create a basic C# script. As always, Ace, make sure the script has a different name than any other class in your project. We'll be declaring local variables in our start method. This means that we won't be able to access these variables outside our start method's body. Again, quickly glossing over this stuff, Ace, since I really want to explain variable scoping in a future video. For now, simply know that anything we declare in the method body of the start method will only be used inside that method. Okay, let's declare a basic variable. Here I'm going to declare an int called x. You'll notice that in order to declare a variable, I have to specify the type I want it to be. In this case, an int. And give it a label. That's a name to you and me, Ace. So now if we try to log a variable out to the console, you'll see that we get an error. Local variable x might not be initialized before accessing. Unfortunately, we need to give our variable a value before we can use it. To do that, we must use the assignment operator. That's the equal sign, Ace, and give it a value. Let's give it a value 0. Now, if I save my script, head back into Unity, drag our script onto one of the game objects so that it gets called, and run our game, you'll see that 0 is logged to the console. Oh, very basic and hopefully pretty easy at this point, Ace. Let's try and assign x to a float number. Simply suffix your 0 with an f and you too can witness the big error underlining our x variable. Cannot convert source type float to target type int. Put simply, Ace, a float literal is not an int, and so we need to change the variable's type before we can assign it to a float value. So if I change int to float, you'll see that the error disappears. If I save the script, head back into Unity, and rerun our game, you'll see that 0 is logged once again. Using the basic operators we looked at in the last video, the card is on your screen now, Ace, we can do some basic mathematics with our x variable. Okay, I want to add 2 to my current x variable's value. To do this, I type out x equals x plus 2. This means x will be assigned the result from the equation x plus 2, which in this case will be 2, since 0 plus 2 equals 2. With me so far, Ace? This should hopefully be pretty easy for you. Now we'll log out the result just to prove it. Save the script, head back into Unity, and rerun the game. And you'll see that 2 is printed. Exactly what we expected, Ace. Let's copy what we've just done and place it below. We'll be doing the same mathematical operation to the x variable, but since the variable's value is changed to 2, we should expect to see 4 logged to the console. Save the script, head back into Unity, and rerun the game. And you'll see that 2 is logged and so is 4. Very basic algebra here, Ace, but this is the fundamentals of coding. Feel free to experiment with this for now, Ace. I don't want to move on to anything further until I've discussed more of the operators with you. This is super basic variable assignment in C#. And that's it. Rate, comment, and subscribe, Ace. Thank you so much for 300 plus subs. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with any suggestions. Thank you for watching this, and I'll see you in the next video.